Requirements. In this topic, we are going to discuss about 3GPP RAN requirement and IMT 2020 requirement. So we can see in this chart from IMT Advanced to IMT 20. This is from 3GPP specs. So here we have IMT 2020 have 8 key capability that is identified at high level for IMT 2020. This capability is generated by IMT 2020 and documented with the help of International Mobile Telecommunication. So ITU or International Telecommunication Unit, you can see here ITU. ITU are defined a set of capabilities needed for an IMT 2020 technology to support the 5G use cases and user scenario identified through the input from the regional bodies, research project, operators, administration, and other organizations. So whatever the KPI, you can see this is designed and developed by so many vendors and operators, and they reach to the one point, what is the requirement during the IMT 2020. So there are total 13 capability defined in ITUR. Okay, but out of 13 capability, 8 were selected as a key capability. So this 8 key capability as a selected as a key capability. If you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So these are the most important key capability, and those 8 key capability we can see in the spider wave diagram. So this is the spider wave diagram we can see. And each category we can compare with the IMT Advanced to IMT 2020 and how much difference we achieve from IMT Advanced to IMT 2020. So number one, we can see peak data rate. In IMT Advanced, it was 1 Gbps, but in the 5G or IMT 2020, it reached to the 20 Gbps. User experience data rate. In IMT Advanced, it was 10 Mbps. But in the 5G or IMT 2020, it reached to the 100 Mbps per second. And this means wherever you want to test, this is applicable whenever the number of subscriber is high, and whenever you want to test anywhere, you have to get minimum 100 Mbps speed in IMT 2020. Number third, we have the spectrum efficiency. In this diagram, we can see spectrum efficiency in IMT Advanced, it was 1x, but in IMT 2020, it reached to the 3x. It means right now, whatever the 20 MHz bandwidth you have, that bandwidth we are not utilizing completely, but in the 5G network for the IMT Advanced, it will achieve up to 3x time more. Then we have the mobility. Mobility we have in IMT Advanced, if you see, it was 350 km per hour, but in the 5G network, it reached to the 500 km per hour speed. And mobility is the main important key capability that is defined as a mobile speed, and the target of 500 km per hour is envisioned in the particular for the high speed train and is only a moderate increase from the IMT Advanced to see in IMT Advanced it was 350, but it just increased up to the 500 km per hour speed. Now we have the latency. Latency is main important. If you see in IMT Advanced, it was 10 milliseconds, but in the 5G network or IMT 2020, it reached to the 1 millisecond. And latency basically defines the contribution by the radio network to the time from when the source send a packet to when the destination receive. It means whatever the packets we are sending from the base station to the subscriber and whatever the time it will take, that is called latency. In earlier time it was 10 milliseconds, now it has changed to the 1 millisecond. Now we have the connection density, and connection density is also important KPI. Why? Because in this time our services and use cases changed. You can see earlier it was 10 to power 5, now it reached to the 10 to power 6, that means 1 million subscriber. So connection density basically is a KPI that is connected or accessible device per unit area. The target is relevant for the MMTC use scenario with a high density of the connected device, but an EMMB dense indoor office can also give a high connection density. That's why connection density this time it has changed to the 1 million subscriber. Now we have the network efficiency. Network efficiency, it was 10x, 1x in the IMT advance, but in the 5G network, it reached to the 100x. Network efficiency is also important KPI because it will improve in the energy consumption. Now the last one is the area traffic capacity. Area traffic capacity is another dependent capability actually, which depend not only on the spectrum efficiency, but also on the bandwidth availability. So that's why area traffic capacity is equal to spectrum efficiency of bandwidth multiplied by transreception point density. So this is important. Earlier it was 0.1, now it's 10 to the 10 megabits per second square meter actually. So this was the overall of the IMT Advanced to IMT 2020 and how it's changed from last generation to this generation. Now we can see the 3GPP RAN requirement. So 3GPP had different RAN requirement, performance measurement and requirement. So here first one is the peak data rate. Peak data rate is downlink 20 Gbps, uplink 10 Gbps. Peak spectral efficiency 30 bits per second hertz and 50 bits per second hertz. So peak spectrum efficiency also changed. Now we have spectrum scalability. Yes, we have multiple spectrum, that's why we can use, like in LTE we have 1.4, 3, 5, 10, 20 MHz bandwidth. The same applicable here also for the 5G. We have 5 MHz bandwidth, 10 MHz, 20 MHz up to 100, and in FR2 we have 400 MHz bandwidth. Bandwidth we have to follow IMT 2020. Bandwidth scalability, yes, we have the bandwidth scalability also in the 5G network. Control plane latency, it will support 10 millisecond. User plane latency, it will support 0.0 and 5 millisecond in AOLCC in one way. It means from base station to the subscriber. User plane latency, EMBB one way, 4 millisecond. Latency for infrequent small packet, 10 second or 20 bytes packet. That is applicable for the MMTC. Mobility interruption time 0 millisecond this time. Mobility up to 500 km per hour speed, that we can support to the 5G network. Inter-system mobility, yes, it will applicable. Reliability 1 minus 10 to power 5 in 1 millisecond. So this is applicable to the release 15. In the release 16, it will change to the 1 minus 10 to power minus 6. Battery life support 10 to 15 years. EV energy efficiency, so this is depend upon the utilization. Cell transreception point or transreception point spectral efficiency, that we have 3 multiplied by IMT advanced requirement. Area traffic capacity 10 megabits per square meter. So area traffic capacity depend upon your bandwidth and transreception density. Transreception spectral efficiency 3 multiplied by IMT advanced requirement. User experience data rate 100 Mbps in downlink and 50 Mbps in uplink. It means wherever you test the user data, you have to achieve minimum this much. User experience data rate, user spectral efficiency at 5 percentile. So 3 multiplied by age. IMT advance. So spectrum efficiency basically what means? Spectrum efficiency means whatever the data throughput per hertz of a spectrum and per cell or rather per unit of radio equipment, that is called spectrum efficiency VR. Connection density 1 million device per square meter, kilo square meter. नेटवर्क एनर्जी एफिशिएंसी क्वालिटी एंड क्वांटिटी केपीआई इट्स डिपेंड अपॉन द यूटिलाइजेशन ईएमबीबी एक्सट्रीम कवरेज सो 140 टू 143 डीबी लॉस मैक्सिमम कपलिंग इट सेम लाइक योर आरएसआरपी राइट नाउ इन एलटी वी हैव -140 आरएसआरपी द सेम थिंग वी एप्लीकेबल टू द 5G आल्सो आईओटी कवरेज और एमएमटी कवरेज मैक्सिमम कपलिंग लॉस दैट इज 164 फॉर 160 बिट्स पर सेकेंड इट मीन्स फॉर दिस इज बेसिकली फॉर द इंडोर कवरेज सो दैट्स वाई इट्स रिक्वायर्ड सपोर्ट ऑफ वाइड रेंज ऑफ सर्विस यस एप्लीकेबल